to my countrywoman, the girls of Malolos. When I wrote No Limit Tanghari, I asked myself the question, whatever bravery was common thing in the girls of our people. I broke back to my recollection and reviewed those I had known since my infancy, but there were only few seems to come up to my ideal. There was, it is true, an abundance of girls with agreeable manners, beautiful ways, and modest demeanor, but there was in all admixture, servitude, and deference to the words of whims of their so-called spiritual father. Due to excessive kindness, modesty, and perhaps ignorance, these seems faded plants sown and their rare darkness having flowered without perfume and fruits with soap. However, the news of what happened on Malolos reached us. I saw my error. I great was rejoicing after all. Who is to blame me? I didn't know Malolos nor its girls, except one called Emilia and her new by name only. Now that you have responded to our first appeal in interest of welfare of the people, now that you have the set an example to those who like you long to have their eyes opened and delivered from servitude, new hopes are weakened in us. We now even dare to face adversity because we have you for allies and are confident of victory. No longer does Filipino stand with her head bowed, nor does she spend her time on her knees, because now she is weakened by hope in the future. No longer will the mother contribute to keeping her daughter in the darkness and bring her up in competent and moral annihilation. And no longer the science of all science consists in blind submissions to any unjust order or example to extreme complacency, nor will continuous smile and be deemed the only weapon against or insult or humble to your inferable financial of all tribulation. You know that the will of God is different from the priest. The religiousness does not consist of long periods spent of earnest, nor in endless prayers, big rosaries and grimy scapularies, but in spotless conduct, firm intention of upright judgment. You also know that prudence does not consist in blindly obeying any whim of this Joslan, but obeying only that which reasonable and just, because blind obedience it is itself cause on the origin those whims, and those guilty of it are really to be blamed.
Ako si Basilia Tantoco.
Maalam na magbati ang ating pinararating at maligayang oras ng pagdating sa mga pinuno at kasabing magiting at sa dakilang pundadora natin. Sumilang na ngayon sa unang pagkakataon, samahang malaya na walang ibang layon kundi kapakanan ng babae isulong